test your hearing as well after we've cleaned your ears out a little bit. Just going to do some basic tests. We're going to put some headphones on you just to check how long you can hear tones for, different frequencies, check your audio range, like whether you can still hear sort of high frequencies. As we get older, these are the frequencies that tend to sort of fall out first. Yes, I'm Dr. James. You can just call me Dr. or James, either one. We're gonna just go over some information first, alright? We have all your basic info. This is more to get to the root of the problem and see what we can do to help and how long you've been experiencing these issues for, okay? Okie doke. Remind me of the first line of the address again. Okay. We'll just bring you up. Here you are. Okay. How long have you been experiencing the issues with the hearing? Okay. Have you recently had any kind of cold or chest infection? Any throat issues or actual soreness within your ears? And you had antibiotics for that, yeah? Alright. It says here, just a 5-day course, clear that up. Alright. Any lingering effects from that, anything? Alright, okay. Do you regularly wear earphones, headphones, this kind of thing? Okay. And how many hours a day would you say you wear them for? Listen loudly, mid-volume. It's fine. It's fine, we're all guilty of that. I tend to listen to loud music in the gym, a lot louder than I should, but, you know, as we get older, we need to protect our hearing. Do you struggle with speech, sort of hearing what people are saying? You tend to miss the starts of sentences, okay? What about whistling, high frequencies, tinnitus, anything like that? Yeah, tinnitus is just a kind of, it's an artificial mental sound that our brain creates in our ears, which makes us think we're hearing sort of a frequency. It can be very loud and quite intrusive in some people's lives, but there are treatments, and it can also be a underlying issue that's kind of connected to some other things, so... Hopefully, if we can figure those out, we can help prevent it. Okay, well, first things first, I'm just gonna have a little look over. I'm gonna pop some gloves on, alright? Keep things sanitary. Okay. Do you have any photosensitivity? Sensitive to bright light? I do have to use a little bit of light to look at the ear area. I'll try and avoid getting it in your eyes, okay? Here we are. Yeah, it's not nice having hearing issues. Stop by looking that way over there, please. which looks to be red. Just let me know if it's tender, okay? If I press here, is that tender? Not too bad, by here. Just here. See, this must have been causing you some distress. That's a shame. How irritated would you say your ears are on a scale of 1 to 10? 10 being it kind of takes over your life, and 0 being, you know, not a problem. Yeah, so enough to cause you some distress. I can see. Down for a second, I'm just gonna have a look at your scalp. Okay. Okay, well, I think before we test your hearing, we should give it a little bit of clean first, right? First things first, I'm going to wipe them down with a cleaning solution. Don't worry, it's skin friendly. It's all natural. Okay. Still a bottle up. And this is just normal paper, toilet paper. Unfragranced. Just over here. Good. You're doing very well. Okay. All right. I've got another solution here. Just gonna spritz this around your hair. It's just a gentle mist. It helps to start dislodging the wax. Just kind of loosen it up and start to break down some of the harder dry skin. Okay. Alrighty, I'm just gonna protect your face with my glove. Alright. So just look that way for me. Alrighty. Okay. Good. That's very good. And now over here. Syringe. Don't worry, there's no needle. It's just for the extraction of the wax. I'm just going to gently pry with my tool. It's just going to remove some of the harder bits in there, okay? Alrighty. Good. Just gently sort of picking it. so I'm just gonna be extra careful with this, okay? Extra careful. Extra careful. There we go. Okay. Good. You're doing so well. Well done. Alrighty. Just move your head that way slightly. Chin down. Side of your head, okay? Just here. Now, I'd like you to close your eyes and I'm gonna rustle one of my gloves and I just want you to point in the direction or say left or right, okay? Just so I can know that it's the same on both sides, okay? And make sure that the sound is equal volume on both sides, okay? Hopefully it's not sounding muffled or closed. Good. Yeah, we're good. Good. Yeah, that's both, obviously. Further away, alright? So the sound is going to be more faint. I just want you to, again, tell me left or right, okay? So I'm going to come all the way higher. Ready? And headphones on you now. Okay. So, I'm just gonna... Okay. Now, you're gonna hear some tones in either one of your ears. First of all, I want you to say which ear you hear the tone in, okay? And then I want you to say now when you stop hearing it, okay? Just load these up. Okay, first tone. And just let me know when you no longer hear the sound. Second. Response time is good as well. Fourth tone, ready? Okay. And just let me know when you no longer hear it. Okay. Very good. I've also got some atmospheric sort of weather sounds lined up. These are just captured sort of out and about in various situations. I'm just going to play them to you. Firstly, I want you to tell me that they're clear and you can hear them audibly and everything is all good there. And also what they are, okay? They're all pretty recognizable, alright? Okay, so... Load up the atmospheric sounds. Ready? And... First scene. Issues with high-end frequencies, it seems. So I'm just going to try to remove some of the inner earwax. Obviously before we got the sort of outer bar, but down the ear canal there is often wax that's lodged in there. A certain amount of wax is healthy, but a build-up or a congestion, as we call it, is detrimental. So I'm just going to a syringe. No needle, of course. I'm going to spray it to make sure it's sanitary. Okay, good. Alright, now I'm just going to come around this side first and begin extracting some of that wax, okay? Little bit over here. center here, and I want you to tell me if it sounds equal on both sides, okay? Sounding equal. Okay, next, I'm gonna ask you to tell me how long you can hear the frequency for, okay? We're gonna start on your right side, okay? So I'm just gonna hold this here. Ready? Okay, good. So around 5 seconds, that's about average. Ready? Sex. I'm just gonna hit it at the other end. Makes a slightly different sound, okay? Ready? Much shorter, so about 3 seconds. Obviously, that's a higher frequency. Mid-frequency perception is good. Alright, we're gonna try the right side now, okay? I'm just gonna bring this here. Ready? Good. 7 seconds, much better. Try that again. Sounding equal. Yeah. Good. Lastly, give another spritz of decongestion just before I give you some prescription, okay? This is what I'm going to prescribe to you today. It's a decongestion and also a numbing spray. It should help ease the pain or soreness. It also stops it from itching, and it has anti-inflammatory properties, which obviously stop it from getting red or inflamed, or it should calm it down quite a bit. I imagine your antibiotics are helping, but they should assist in the process, okay? Alright. So just look that way. Good, very good. Ready? Just rub that in, okay? Good, you're doing very well. Alright, now we've cleared your ears. The last thing I'm going to do is repeat the whispering test, okay? This time I'm going to say letters, alright? Now, hopefully you should be able to hear me a little bit better. I'm going to start a little further away and then come in closer to you as we go, okay? And then vice versa, and I'll pull back as well. this side. Okay, ready? No peeking. No lip reading. L. R. A. T. Z. Residual lasting effects of that. It's possible you had an ear infection too. What tends to happen when we get our bodies get infected, so we get a chest infection or a throat infection. Obviously these areas are all interlinked, so one can lead to another, can lead to another, and it can quite easily spiral into making you quite ill. Obviously we caught it in good time, but it does appear that this area and this area have obviously got some kind of mild to moderate infection. Obviously our sense of smell and taste go, and our sense of hearing and even our eyesight can be affected by these kind of things. It's a bit of a mishmash of symptoms, really. I don't think, looking at your family history, that you have anything particularly to be worried about in terms of, there's no deafness or history of hearing problems or excess. persevering loss beyond what you would get with just aging and getting older, which of course happens to all of us. So no cause for concern there, as far as I can see. You do have a little bit of excess wax buildup, but I imagine that's probably from being congested, the area being sort of itchy, and obviously you not wanting to kind of like get in there with your fingers, and I imagine cleaning it can be quite painful when it's infected like that. So I'm going to prescribe this neurospritz. It's just a normal decongestion of ears, and like I said, it's got anti-inflammatory properties. It's just going to calm down the area when it's getting sort of raw and horrible, and I'm also going to prescribe you something to break down the wax. Don't use this right away. Start with the antibiotics and the first spray, and then once the redness starts to die down, the anti-inflammation properties start to work, then you can throw in the cleaning and start getting a little more vigorous with it. As I always say, don't use Q-tips directly in your ear. It's okay for these parts on the outside, but do not push them into your ear canal, okay? Because you will just push whatever's there further in and block the canal more, which is obviously not what we want to do. Yeah, so after about 3 to 4 days, start using that. Clean it once in the morning, once in the evening. If it starts to get itchy, just use the first spray. You can obviously take normal painkillers like ibuprofen, paracetamol, these kind of things with it. Should all just help you feel better. Yeah. As for the hearing, obviously don't use in-ear earphones. If you need to listen to music, listen quietly for no longer than 2 hours a day and use over-the-ear headphones, okay? Anything that goes directly in your ear can just make the infection worse. Push the wax in further, and it's just not what we want, okay? If you have a preference towards them, obviously you can resume normal use after the infection is cleared up, but I'd still recommend over-the-ear earphones, headphones, as the better thing for your health, okay? Very good. Obviously, don't listen to loud music. You shouldn't be doing that anyway. Excessively loud music. Do you play video games? These kind of things. Yeah, well, just try and keep the volume within a safe sort of reasonable area. Okay. Well, we shall see you again in about 2 weeks for a checkup, see how you're getting on. Keep taking the antibiotics, use the sprays that I've prescribed, and just some good practices should help us get you.